Mike and Paul from Pacific Bike and Ski invited me out for a gravel ride. A gravel ride basically is we're using a gravel bike, which is a road bike with fatter tires, or a cyclocross bike, which is basically a gravel bike as well. So they invited me for a Thursday morning ride. They do it pretty regularly. So this ride, we rode about 24 miles, and we stopped along the Snoqualmie River for a boil up, as we'd say in Newfoundland. But here, we just stopped for some coffee. So Derek also joined us. He's on the orange bike. It's a Santa Cruz Stigmata. Very nice bike.
For rides like this, man, you can get a tire like the one I'm running.
Yeah.
It's a big, higher volume. Like, yeah. I'm running this thing like at 30 PSI.
Yeah.
And, man, is it nice, man. It just levels everything out.
Cool.
And they roll fast, too, which is nice.
Whenever you get a chance to ride with stronger riders, it's always a good thing to do. They're going to push you. They're going to push you both on the flats, and they're going to push you on the climbs, and even on descents. So you're going to be pushing your level a little bit, and you know that's really good training. And so as I train for cyclocross, it's nice to ride with other riders who can push my level. So the ride started with a pretty steep climb in the very beginning, and then we had a really nice downhill. It was very fast, and then we basically hit the Snoqualmie Valley Trail. So here we are still descending. And once we descend, we have to go on some local roads for a little bit until we get to the trailhead. So this road here is a mix of gravel and old pavement that has broken up a bit, so some sections had some ruts and everything you had to watch out for, some loose gravel. So it was a pretty fun, though sometimes sketchy descent. So it was a cold morning, and about 2 days before I did a test ride and my frozen finger ride, where I wanted to see what kind of gear I should be using now that the weather's changed a bit. And I'm wearing my winter gloves here, and I've got a raincoat on over my cycling jersey. And the raincoat is basically acting as a windbreak, and it kept me warm enough. So here we are turning on the Snoqualmie Valley Trail.
Ooh, now I know what that hill is at the end. The hill back to his place.
Oh, yeah, probably back.
It's a circle of life.
Right.
That's cool, man.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful ride this morning. There's a lot of fog these days. And then in the morning it starts to burn off as you get to watch the sun come up.
That's nice.
So at some points the lighting was just really perfect. Beautiful fog along here. Since it was probably about 7 a.m. at this time, there was one road we had to cross, and quite a lot of traffic, so we had to wait a little while. But we were rewarded when we got to the other side, because we got to ride through some cornfields, and the light was perfect. It was just really golden. I don't think it gets picked up as well here as it was in person, but the corn was really just beautiful. So partway down the trail, we turned off, and we went a little bit overland. And so we navigated out to the river, and we found a spot that was actually overlooking the river. It had a drop off where some of the bank had fallen away, so we couldn't get down to the river, but we had a boil up above it. My pot actually tipped over, so I had to hold on to it while it was boiling. This is an espresso pot. The water goes underneath, and there's a little coffee holder in the bottom, and then as the pressure builds up, it forces the steam up, and you basically get an espresso. Kind of get a four-shot espresso out of it, which is my morning, my normal morning. Yep, four shots of espresso. That's how I get rolling.
The coffee shop.
Dude, I still. Have you seen the Soho bike?
So after a bit of chatting, we started to do some bushwhacking to see if we could grab back to the trail by heading through the farmland. but we ended up having to turn around. There was just too many blackberry bushes. And we had a flat going through the field, and Paul had to basically put a tube in, or replace his tube, before we rolled back and we hit the big climb back up to the start.
Kind of stuck, and we can't
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed, please subscribe.